Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to make your own crystal points. So you have to start off with actual crystals first. I create a 1-to-1 ratio of the putty and shape it around each of the crystals. I want to make sure that the bottom of it is flat. If it's not, you'll notice that the crystals start to fall over. I do catch this in time, but you don't want it to harden that way. So here I am just putting a bunch of crystals in the putty and shaping the putty around the crystal. Once you finally get the putty around all of your crystals, you want to set them aside and let them dry for about 20 minutes or as directed. Okay, so once your putty has hardened, you can take out your crystal points, and what's left is the mold of those points. So now you can add whatever you want into the molds, and you'll have a variation of different colors and glitters to use for your geodes. I decorated my points by placing the pigment directly onto the surface of the mold, but you can actually mix your pigments into the resin and then pour the resin. It's really up to you whichever way you want to do it. Because I'm making different colors, I just poured clear resin and then added my glitters. I would actually recommend doing a large batch of the same color and mixing everything into your resin, which means that you would mix your glitters and pigments into your resin and then pour the resin into the molds. Once the resin is poured, you just put the molds aside and wait for them to cure. Just read the directions on what your resin says is a good wait time. Once your resin has cured, you can pull the new crystals out from the mold. Look how cool they are. They look exactly like the original crystals, except with different colors. To shine them up, all you need to do is pour some resin on them. So you can place them in the geode and then pour the resin, and they'll end up being very shiny. I hope you enjoyed this little mini tutorial. And now you can make your own crystals to add to your geodes.